the idea of The Secret of Blackrock came from an article that I found online about a log that floats in a lake in America called the Old Man of the Lake. And this log was like known by the villagers, and they gave it a personality. So then when I discovered that, I started imagining what would be below the surface of the water. And I decided that there would be like an old man character, and the top of the log would be the very top of his head. So after that, I kept drawing that over and over again. And then eventually I thought of the idea of, what if there was like a lighthouse that had the same personality, a lighthouse that had a character underneath. And then I worked backwards from there. I guess the relationship came about because most of my childhood, I think I used to visit my parents in a little town like that was off the coast of Newcastle called Cullercoats. And that has a very strong fishing community. And I don't know, I always remember seeing those families. They always seem like very like tight. Just like their relationships were really interesting. And then I guess I thought like building an adventure story around one of those families would be really nice. They feel like they're kind of, a lot of those old fishing families are a bit like untouched by time. You know what I mean? They're quite like old fashioned. And I think I like illustrated worlds that are set in that kind of period, you know, not too much technology or anything like that. The element of kind of magic and that side of things was pretty much every single book I loved as a kid had that. I was talking earlier about Maurice Sendak and Where the Wild Things Are. Every book I think I ever make, I want to recreate the feeling I got when I read that book for the first time, when he just disappears into the world. And it's like, in each book I think that I do, I always try and find that moment where you jump from the regular world into the imagined world, you know? And I'm always trying to find new ways to kind of describe that, I guess. A lot of the inspirations, I guess, come from, I think, animated movies more than maybe illustration now. Like, there are still lots of books I go back, like I was saying, I'm gonna like horribly mispronounce the name, but you know, the Ernest and Celestine. I discover new old illustrators and I'm inspired by like the way they classically worked, but then also stuff like Studio Ghibli, things like that. Any, especially Spirited Away. I remember seeing that with my dad when it first came out in the cinema, and then we went to Chinatown and got like buns, and it kind of felt like, even though it's Chinatown and not Japantown, it felt like I just disappeared inside the movie. And yeah, I got loads of inspiration from that. And basically any movie they do is amazing. I have a book that's coming out April next year called A Mouse Called Julian that I'm really happy about. It's more kind of like traditional, I think, like inspired by like Beatrix Potter and all of those kind of like old English illustrated stories. But then, I don't know, I think most of my projects come from just like anything. I don't think I plan ahead too much. It'll be like, I try and go to museums a lot, and then if I find something, hopefully it'll come up with a story idea or something will appear. But, oh, I'm also doing the third in the Brownstone stories, which I can't reveal anything about. I've just finished illustrating a book about the life of Edmund Hillary called Everest, which was amazing to do. I can now draw snowy mountains with my eyes closed. But yeah, it was incredibly inspiring, and it makes me want to go on some actual adventures, I think. In terms of trying out animation, I did do it in university, but I realised that I also liked having a social life. I think I get too obsessed, and because my like references for animation are so amazing, like Studio Ghibli and stuff, I'm going to be disappointed if I can't recreate exactly how they animate. But I would love to see my work animation. Every book I write, I imagine it in my head as an animation, and then I work backwards. So my first book that I got published, Arthur and the Golden Rope, has just been acquired by DreamWorks, and that might be being turned into an animation, and that will, like, I don't think I'm ready. It'll blow my mind. If I was going to be the hero of a children's story, most of the children's stories I really liked, I think their heroes were, I don't know, like, say Max from Where the Wild Things Are, he's not exactly, like, the nicest character. God, who would I be? I don't know, I think Celestine. Is that how you say it? Celestine, yeah. Just because I'd love to go into her little mouse world. And I think harvesting teeth would be quite a fun job. And I love the little, like, cape she wears. I don't think I could get away with rocking that as I am now, but if I was a tiny mouse, then I'd be able to wear that cape, which would be pretty awesome.